Hey everybody, it's Brooke and we're back for episode 2 of Heartstopper. This episode is called Family. We were introduced to Charlie's parents in the last episode, so I'm betting it has some stuff to do with them. Last episode, we started off on a really, really bright note. It seemed pretty happy the whole time. Nick and Charlie are happy. Nick is considering coming out to more people. He had come out to his mom at the end of season 1, and he's now come out to his friend Imogen. She reacted really well, like, she's an ally. If you know, you know. And she was great about it, and I think that made him feel really good. We all know not everyone's going to be great about it, but it's nice when the first people you tell are. I am a little worried about Charlie. He is very concerned about making sure the coming out experience for Nick is really positive and nothing like what his experience was like. We found out in season 1 that Charlie was kind of forced out and went through a lot of bullying, which is awful to hear. I really wish we could move past that in society, you know? Especially bullying people for just who they love and who they are. It's like, what is your problem? as for Tao and L, it's still very obvious they like each other. L was really clear. She made, like, real flirting. Like, she made it pretty clear. The only way she could have been clearer is if she straight out said, hey, I like you in this way. Do you like me? Which sometimes I feel like is what the move you should make. But that's kind of hard to do, especially in high school. I think we don't know for sure what's going on there, but I think he's scared to ruin their friendship, and it's leading to her thinking he doesn't like her, and she talked to Darcy and Tara about feeling like she needs to move on. They're really supportive of her, which it's awesome to see those friendships. Those two seem to be doing great. I didn't notice any, like, storylines for them yet, but they are being really, like, supportive characters in Elle's story right now. Isaac seems to be feeling a little seventh wheel-ish, but that could change with Imogen coming in. They could, like, be friends, and, like, when the couples are off being coupley, they can just be friends that hang out. Imogen has pretty much joined the group. Nick came out to her. I think I mentioned she was great. She did tell him, though, that she has a crush on Ben. That can be a problem. They obviously cannot tell her that, one, Ben is, well, I think Ben is gay. I don't think he's bisexual like Nick was. I don't remember if he fully came out in season 1 though, so if you do know, can you let me know in the comments? But they obviously, you can't tell her that. They can't really warn her that he's kind of an asshole without explaining that what he did to Charlie, and you can't do that without outing him, and that is very complicated. I think you could get away with just saying, like, I know some people who have dated him and he wasn't very nice, just so you know. I just wanted you to know that. But when someone likes someone, especially in high school, they sometimes have blinders on, so I am a little worried about that. But overall, I really liked episode 1, and I am ready to dive into episode 2. I have a Zoom meeting at 11, but it is only 9:42, so I feel like I might be able to get to through 2 more episodes, do my work stuff, and then hopefully binge a bunch more. If you're watching episode 2 the day I'm posting it, and you're like, I need to see episodes 3 and 4, I need her reactions, they're up on Patreon! I have 2 tiers. I have a $2 tier where you can see these YouTube cut early access, or a $5 tier where you can watch my full reactions. I'm really excited. I also, if this is the first video you somehow find me on, I'm doing Buffy and She-Ra right now, as well as a monthly movie night. And I'm working on getting stuff that's already up on YouTube up on Patreon, so it's kind of a little bit of a mix, but definitely everything new I'm recording is going straight up, so. I hope you guys are ready. I got my blanket. I got my dog. I am so ready for episode 2. I feel like I'm gonna cry at some point, but hopefully not. Hopefully it's only happy. Sometimes I cry even when it's happy. Alright, let's go.
Charlie's always been a high achiever.
Oh, parent teacher conference.
His grades have been slipping.
He is a teenager with a boyfriend. Okay, that happens. Oh no.
Well, as long as he.
That teacher seems harsh, but like a good teacher. Yeah, that's.
Set the top grades in his GCSEs.
He's failed to hand in several homework assignments.
Still haven't completed your history coursework essay. If you don't finish it, then that'll be a failed grade.
Okay, but what are these teachers doing to, like, help? When students fall behind and stuff like this, I feel like there's something wrong, but people are just like, fix it. Like, Charlie's parents give me the... Maybe I'm wrong. I need to just watch. But they're kind of giving me the parent vibes where they don't actually, like, talk to him about what's going on. Like, how do they have no idea how he's doing?
You need to start focusing on your schoolwork.
I know getting your first boyfriend is...
That's a hard combo, but she's not wrong.
It's not Nick's fault.
Charlie!
You've been going around each other's houses almost every day.
They're not saying it's his fault.
It's no wonder you haven't done your coursework.
Fuck off!
I think it would be fair to set, like, a boundary of, hey, your homework needs to be done before you can go to Nick's house. I think that's a fair boundary. Like, this is hard because I'm not a teen anymore who's like, get it up fair, mom and dad. I'm like, no, I think it's fair to have, like, hey, first 2 hours after school, you do your homework. We see that it's done. You can go wherever you are.
A few weeks to finish it.
It needs to be a complete ban.
Oh, these two need to talk before they talk to the kid.
Nick is not allowed around our house and you are not allowed around his.
Just write the essay and then you can go. It's fine.
Mom, make me one.
Who the fuck is that?
Like that, David?
Please.
No one seems
time.
Happy, well, very happy to see him.
I won't, darling. Don't worry.
I don't trust his brother. You might want to take that down. Yeah, that's fair. But write the paper. Yeah, obviously. Okay, but you could, like, work on your coursework together. Like... over Zoom or something. Like, Imogen does have a type, huh? Attracted to Charlie is her type. They're gonna have a prom?
I'm so excited.
And a trip to Paris?
You could totally wear a suit. You look amazing. You mean we can't be Fiona and Shrek?
I'm kind of looking for some help.
Help.
I'm really excited, but I don't think I can do this alone.
Oh my god, yes! I'm so in. Blue will make like everyone's outfits look
girl,
like
trust
amazing.
Girls to plan prom, okay?
I think that prom should be pirate themed.
That'd be kind of sick, though.
Tao wants to meet up tonight.
Oh my god, say yes.
No. Oh, you need to put some distance between
yeah, if he's not going to make a move.
This is your chance.
Give me a phone. I'll send him a text.
Guys.
No, no. Last person I would let send it. Oh, I just want them to be happy too. Yeah, he's study time. Fuck off, Ben. He didn't do anything. He just like looked at them. But you know.
Told Mr. Freak I borrowed your pen and needed to give it back.
They're literally so cute. Oh my god. Ben, what is your problem? You didn't want to date him.
I wanted to say hi.
No one likes you, Ben. Sorry, it's just my natural.
Told you not to talk
stab
about
him
God, you
with
hate
the pen.
So much. I hate you because you literally are so.
Yeah, like was that not clear? Yeah, they're gonna. You can't put them in there. They're gonna like fight or something.
Fail your math GCSE on Monday, but I ain't gonna let you disrupt everyone else's study time.
That was just a misunderstanding.
It wasn't. You assaulted him.
Wait. I was going through some personal stuff.
I don't care.
I don't care. You don't assault people.
You hurt him. And who knows if you do the same with Imogen. He thinks you're this perfect boyfriend, but you are just the same as me.
No, he doesn't ignore him in the hallways and assault him. Don't Charlie, check Charlie, other Charlie, people's
Charlie,
hot.
Can you give it back?
Stop it.
Give me that back.
She's sending
three give it back.
Are you even doing the coursework? No, write your paper. Oh, he's gonna get in trouble. Nawi! They have bad days. He's nothing like Ben. I hate Ben.
I'm stealing this, just so you know.
Oh, I know.
Nelly! Nelly's the real star of this show. I know there has to be conflict for it to be a show, but I love these happy moments.
I'm definitely gonna fail math.
No, you're gonna nail it, my boy. Are you good at math? They do kiss a lot in public places for people who don't want to get caught. Nelly's like, all right, I'll protect the gays. Nelly's the real ally. Oh. His parents are gonna catch him. Oh, that's so cute. That outfit is slay. Elle always is so fashionable.
Not gonna lie, this is kind of making me feel more nervous. My application base.
I haven't finished mine yet.
Oh, same.
I haven't even started.
Oh my god, babe. Same.
It's an art school thing.
Oh. I'm Naomi, by the way.
I'm Elle.
Oh, new friends. I'm really glad because Elle was really shy about making new friends in the last season. I'm glad she's being really open.
Everyone knowing you as the trans girl. Here I could just be Naomi.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
I really do.
I'm glad they found each other. Just friends.
Oh, what's that Elle?
His mom loves her.
Are they Jyoti Shankar Lexic Fanum?
Yeah.
I like that we're seeing more of everybody's home lives this season.
How are you feeling about maths this morning? Because I still don't get quadratic equations, so I'm probably going to...
Nobody likes Ben. You can't.
Why are you dating Ben?
Not the time to tell her. She also has to take the math test.
What did he do?
You can't tell her.
I can't tell you.
That many friends. But Ben is one of the few people who actually likes me. And he's been lovely to me. So whatever happened in the past, he's nicer now.
I love that shot, though. My boy, I don't know how important these tests are. They seem very important. You gotta focus. Oh, no. Breathing exercises.
I'm here to cheer you up after your terrible exam.
Friend. Boyfriend. But friend of his brother is home. I don't trust that man.
That boy of yours is here.
Tao, you did not come here just to ask me about my maths exam.
Yeah, come on.
I've been a bit weird. So I thought I'd come out and see if you wanted to hang out this evening.
Going out tonight with Naomi and Felix.
We're he going could to a club come.
That is under 18 nights.
Club? Wow.
I know.
Maybe we could have that art day at the weekend or something.
Oh, this is so hard.
I don't know.
But he thinks she's falling away because she has new friends, but she's actually falling away because she likes him. I can't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is so stressful. Fine.
Sorry.
No.
Oh my god, I just want to like jump into the screen and be like, you like each other! I thought he was asleep.
Did I fall asleep? Are you tired? Or is this movie just really boring?
Do you want something to eat? Make us some dinner.
No, I'll have something when I get home. I'd have a cup of tea though.
Hey!
Tea's good! Me, the minute there's a dog in any room ever.
Hi.
You're not Nick.
I'm Charlie, and
you're Charlie.
Yeah. Back off, David.
So I'm Nick's older brother.
Run! Well, don't run. You have hot tea. We're watching a movie.
David. We're busy, so you can go away now.
Bye, David. You okay? No one wants you here. David and Ben should hang out. They're both annoying.
Turn my little brother gay.
Not really how that works, you fucking dinkhole.
Actually, you're gonna be gay. At least admit you're gay.
That's. Oh my God, there are real people like this. I didn't want to tell you. Oh, and then you're there, and they're fighting, and oh, this is my hell.
What?
Like a homophobic prick.
Guys, what is going on?
Why did you tell him about Charlie?
I didn't, darling.
Mum didn't tell me. You left a picture of you two kissing on your bedroom wall. I mean, I bet you haven't told Dad yet, have you? Oh my God, imagine what Dad's gonna say.
He's in the kitchen now.
I feel like David is an adult, and you could say, get the fuck out of my house.
Why did you do it? Why are you winding up?
Guys, my emotions are everywhere.
I'm sorry.
I knew this was gonna happen. Like, I had a feeling. Oh. I did mention the photo. I was like, this guy goes into your room like without asking. It's bad. Charlie's gonna blame himself. It's not your fault. It's not Nick's fault. His brother is a douchebag. He is so obviously upset. Just listen to him, please. And don't yell at him. What do you think?
I just wanted to...
Yeah, I don't want to hear it.
No, you need
for the rest of this term.
To listen.
And don't think about sneaking out or you won't be going on the Paris trip.
Learn to talk to your child, not just like... yell at them. Like, something is obviously wrong with him.
Charlie.
Like, he's obviously upset. Dinner.
No. Next.
Okay, but he didn't eat. He needs to eat food. Like, that's just gonna make your stomach hurt worse. And then being hungry is just gonna make it worse. Because people suck. I know they can't have the communication skills they need yet. They're in high school. They need to develop them. But I just want them to be okay. No, that is not it. He should have respected your boundaries. That sometimes you need, because texts, it's hard.
Charlie, this is not your fault.
Yeah, I think he needs to understand
that. I don't care
what
David thinks anyway. But there are still awful people in the world. Like my brother.
Yeah, I think he needs some, like, therapy. You can't protect him from it. He needs to go through his journey. I mean, you could have gone. I guess she didn't invite him. Ugh, that is hard though, when your friend makes a new friend and you don't feel as important anymore. You're still their friend.
Sad about Elle? You remind me of me and Dad.
What? Mom, that's so weird.
She's being supportive. Well, be nice to her.
And I was the outspoken one, so when we lost him...
Oh my God, why is everything sad?
I felt so unbalanced. It was like falling off a cliff, growing up and moving on.
Well, I'm stuck here. Same old
You're
town.
You're gonna grow, too.
Same old town isn't so bad. You have to fight to stay by our side.
Yeah, doing nothing is obviously not helping.
Welcome to fun, huh? Going out on yoga.
But fighting to stay by her side does not mean, like, being mean to her new friends. It means, hey, you're going to this event, I want to try to go too, kind of thing. Being supportive of her new friendships, like, meeting them, being their friends. Just tell her you like her.
I like Elle, okay?
They're like, yeah, we know.
And she probably doesn't even like me back. And this is probably going to destroy our friendship. It's going to destroy our friendship group. I'm going to tell her. Help me.
Oh, okay. I thought she was there. Oh my God. That episode was so emotional. There was so much. One, who knew Nick had a brother? Let's start with him. I don't like him. Let's start with the people I don't like. Nick's brother? Jerk. You don't get to just come back from college and be a jerk to everybody. Like, what is his problem? I logically understand his mom cannot just, like, kick out one of her children, but my brain went, kick him out, he has a dorm room, he can go stay with the dad, get the fuck out of my house if you're gonna make it unsafe based on someone's sexuality. Also, what is that fucking biphobia shit? Like, you're either straight or you're gay, excuse me, sorry, like, do you live under a fucking rock? Like, that's not how it fucking works. Yeah, we hate him. Also, like, respect people's boundaries. You don't go on someone else's phone. You don't go in their room when they're not there without permission. Like, the guy sucks. Like, I don't know. Like, the other person who sucks is Ben. But with Ben, I, in some ways, can, like, not make excuses, but I can be like, okay, Ben is in high school. Ben is in the closet. Like, Ben is obviously not dealing with things the correct way. But he's still young, so you're like he's in high school. Like, no, not everyone dealt with their sexuality the best way in high school. He's still an asshole for what he did to Charlie. Nick is proof that you can be in the closet and still be, like, kind to the person you're interested in. Like, you don't have to treat them like they don't exist. I feel bad for Imogen because it is hard, like, everyone she likes, like, she liked Nick, and then he didn't like her, and they became friends, but now she likes this other guy, and she was so supportive when he told her about Charlie, and I think she wants that reciprocated with Ben, but she doesn't know about Ben's actions, and he did assault Charlie, that is true, and so I can get being worried that he would do something like that to Imogen, but you can't tell her without outing him, and that is really hard. That is a very hard situation to be in because you never want to out someone. But then if someone's safety is involved, that is, I understand why that would be such a complicated, like, feeling. Like, I never would want to be in that situation. And I don't know that I'd make the perfect choice. I don't know if there is a perfect choice in that moment. Going into people we do like, Tara and Darcy are still being really supportive of Elle. On different sides, though, one of them thinks she should keep going for Tao, and one thinks she should move on. They're helping that new girl who seemed really nice. She's planning prom. I bet we'll see prom this season. Let's see. Elle, I like she's making new friends. That is kind of a part of going to a new school or going to college. It's like you make new friends, and they don't replace your old friends. You just have, learning to juggle two friend groups can be hard. It would be nice if Tao could, like, hang out with them and, like, meet them, but I get she's trying to get over him. That situation is so complicated. I am a little worried. Well, I'm kind of a lot worried about Charlie. He's putting so much stress on himself, and then he's not eating, which makes you physically feel sick, plus the other added stress. Like, I really relate to Charlie because I felt like everything that went wrong was my fault. And I had an undiagnosed anxiety disorder in high school. And I feel like that's something he could maybe have too. And, like, you need to go talk to someone about it, at least your doctor, and, like, figure something out there and, like, learn coping techniques and things like that. But that's hard to do if you don't have the most supportive home life and your family is just like, do the thing that you're supposed to do. And it's like, your brain chemistry is different and it's not that easy. Yeah, so I'm a little worried about him. I feel so bad for Nick. His brother's a total douche. I don't know. Last episode was so, there was the inkling of something going bad, and, like, obviously there has to be conflict to tell an interesting story, but it just makes me sad. I think, let me look at the time, guys. I have enough time to watch one more before my work meeting, so I am gonna watch episode 3. Thank you guys for watching so much. Please let me know how you were feeling in this episode in the comments. Maybe let me know what you feel about the, I'd love to talk more about, like, the Ben-Nick-Imogen issue and, like, how you would handle that or how you feel Nick should handle it, because it is complicated. Like, it's easy to look at the world black and white, but it's not at the same time. Like, and I think that's one of the most complicated things that does not have obvious answers for stuff going on right now. So I'd love to hear what you guys think about that. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss an episode. If you'd like to get early access and uncut reactions, you can check out my Patreon in the description. And I just really appreciate all of your support. So thank you so much, and I will see you next time.